I've also had lots to do with going up and down to the NHRC. It's one of the issues, and it's taken perhaps 1.5 years before we got this statement saying that 14 women have been upholding the charge, the complaints that we have been putting on. 14 women have been sexually assaulted during a certain period of time, and it's taken that much time. So you can see during that period how much more has happened. Now, you know, I've got to the stage where I can only think of the long past. Can't think of today because today is in a sense cumulative consequences of the ways in which our state has proceeded. But Indira is here, many others who might be my generation will remember that it's really the emergency. But the emergency at least was the emergency. It was the suspension of the rule of law. It was the suspension of habeas corpus. Even this morning, there's a statement from Palkhiwala saying the dissenting judge, who was the only dissenting judge, in which even habeas corpus was suspended. And he said, you can't do that because the right to life is a fundamental right. That was when there was a certain kind of clamping down, a certain control over the media. Once the emergency was lifted, there was a whole nation which was standing over there ensuring that that government would not come back. Today we are in a situation where you don't have the emergency, you don't need the emergency, because you're actually pitting one set of people against the other, and there is the entire urban yuppie crowd which sees itself as sort of, you know, invested in the development rhetoric, and they don't care at what is happening in certain parts of the country. And I'm struck with the fact that we have to repeatedly keep Chhattisgarh we have to keep struggling about what is happening in Chhattisgarh. And starting off, really, when you go back, I don't know how many times we've been to the Chhattisgarh Bhavan to do demonstration. I mean, literally, one of the demonstrations, they said there's a shoot of strike order and you have to get up now. There's no one over there. The demonstration had moved. It was, I think, a PUDR demonstration. I said, where are they? It was in the days before the emergency, before I was carrying a mobile. I had no idea where the demonstration has moved. Finally, I went to a shop, called friends, and I was told the demonstration is in Jantar Mantar. And I was exploded with anger, saying, Ram Guha says there's 50-50 democracy. We have 50 square feet of democracy, and that is in the Jantar Mantar. You don't have it in the rest of the country. And I'm saying this admittedly because I really want you all to think, what are we doing sitting over here? You know, we are watching from Binayak Sen downwards every stage. Some of us have, I mean, you know, how many times we've had press conferences over Chhattisgarh in the last 1 year or 2 years? Some of us were there when, you know, when Soni Sori was produced in the court, when she said, don't send me to Chhattisgarh, I will be killed off. She is sent in a subterfuge, she's sexually assaulted. That matter is known, it is there in the records of the case in the Supreme Court. We have got no relief. We have got no relief from any quarter, no acknowledgement that this is the face of the state, this is what the state can do. When we wanted to send a team, you remember Vani and I, how many times we went to the NCW to say, you know, we want a team to go. Finally, the women's groups had to girao the NCW before a team was sent to look at the jail. That's the situation that we have been slowly getting into. We've had evidence coming out, you know, the Meena Khalko, we have the magistrate's report, which upholds the fact that this was an ordinary girl picked up, shot, raped and shot. Where is that case now? Is anybody been charged with what they should be? I mean, somebody picked them up. There are these diaries that everybody has. Somebody picked them up. Somebody finally produced that body and said she was supposed to be a Naxalite. Who, you know, who is accountable to who in this country? We are, at the end of the day, we are in a situation where the state is only cares. And I beg to differ. It's true that we may see a more brutal face at the moment with the BJP. But let us remember that this whole scenario in Chhattisgarh began with the Congress government. And it's not only the Congress government, it's also the policy of the state, which has said, we are going to exploit those resources. It's predatory capital which is penetrating in these areas, and that is directly responsible for what is happening in Chhattisgarh today. It is the multinationals, it is the exploitation of the mineral resources. Why is it that it is Jharkhand, Orissa, and Chhattisgarh which is burning at the moment? Because this is the center of the resources that we have. So be in no doubt that we are a liberal state. Of whatever kind. It is not a state in retreat. It is a state that believes it must be strong. Multinational capital can only come in if we have a state that backs them with guns. Otherwise, that capital cannot come in. So that is the situation that we're confronted with. And in that, sexual violence is a systematic means by which you hope you're going to break the resistance of the people. So let's be very clear. It's true that encounters are happening. It's true that various forms of injustice are being unleashed upon the people. There's huge amounts of displacement. There is absolutely nothing by way of development that you get in terms of education and healthcare across the country, but certainly in many parts of these areas which are supposed to be under development. In that situation, here is an aggressive state which is literally eating up its own people. It's killing them and it's gobbling them up. I remember Parveena Hangar saying in the context of Kashmir that what has happened to these characters, has the earth swallowed them up? I think this is a government that's eating its own people. I think we have a state that is literally eating up its own people. I think that what we're seeing as far as Kalluri is concerned, he's only the most visible face of a state which believes, and I want to reiterate this, why is it that there's this statement that circulates that he has a direct connection with the PMO office? It's not, nobody can say anything. It doesn't matter, Raman Singh will go and say to Bela Bhatia, sorry, we'll protect you. But the fact is, there is a direct connection between the state at the center and what Kalluri is doing, and he knows that. That's exactly why he's doing what he's doing. And I think that that's what we are confronted with. Now, in that scenario, some of us have constantly tried to, and in the WSS we have, many people have gone on repeated trips, collected a great amount of material, very systematically. There are young people. There are people who are actually doing things that are quite extraordinary. And I think that the legal team that went to stay in Jagdalpur went straight from their university situations to Jagdalpur run that, what was called Jaglag, and did good work over there. Obviously was a threat, because what is the law? What is a lawyer? What is a committed legal system meant to do? Provide justice to its people. That's what they're actually serving their own profession. They're doing nothing else. But today, even that is extraordinary, because who is actually going to take the kind of risk that you can? And you can see then how things have happened. They have been systematically hounded out of there. You successfully hounded Binaxan out of there. Then you successfully have, gone inch by inch, and you're hounding out people. Soni Sori, because she's an Adivasi, they tried to hound her out, but she went back. She went back, and she is the woman who says, never mind, I know I'm going to be killed at some point of time, but, that's where my work is. That's where I have to go back. So we are seeing new situations, and I think the repeated rounds of fact-finding that we have been doing, and I want to say this because recently there was a program which I didn't see because I never watch CNN. I hate the damn media. At the moment, you've got to avoid it because you only get, what do you got? Press conferences of the various kinds. What are the latest ones that we get? Man Ki Baat. The Man Ki Baat is constantly coming, at the end of the day. And it's not only the Modi who does Man Ki Baat. I think Bhupendra Chaubey does Man Ki Baat, and so does Arnab Goswami. They're all doing Man Ki Baat, apni baat rakhte hain wahan par. Hame kuch nahi. So finally, I don't know how they got it, but they went. They went, and they got one of their reporters to go, and they did this program. But it begins with the fact, Tanushri went, but it begins with Mr. Bhupendra Chaubey standing in front of this, you know, this India Gate and talking about Independence Day, but this is happening, and no one has done anything. I wanted to give him do thappar. I said, no one has done something. What are you saying? I mean, what the hell have people been doing? How many press conferences we have held? These guys know nothing about it, and then suddenly stake territoriality over the thing. Even that, they're eating off the flesh of their own people. I think it's utterly shameful and shocking that this is what they're doing. I would like them to run press conferences on a daily basis, a program on a daily basis on the things that are happening in the country. And I think that's the direction. We can't be silent. There is no way. I don't think we can forgive ourselves, or that history will forgive us, if this is the monstrousness that is going to carry on. It depends on us that we don't stay here quiet and, you know, sort of, okay, one press conference done, go home, now, whatever it is. I think it's very important that we actually build the kind of movement that says we just want, in a sense, bare minimum, the rule of law. The rule of law is, if you don't have the rule of law, why do we have a constitution? Why do we have any set of legal things in place? It seems to me that every institution has let us down, let its people down, but it's even let the process of thinking about what kind of a state are we going to have, even that is an ideal that we have dropped along the way. And I strongly feel that we must all work to recover that space because things are going to get worse. And in that context, I want to say that this is a report that the WSS has compiled. It's got a beautiful photo essay, which we don't have at the moment, but this will come out in the next few days, hopefully. We'd like you all to please circulate this, extend it, and also, if you can, contribute towards it, because we are basically a group like all of you, and we'd like you to keep that in mind.